Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're new, kindly subscribe, like, share and comment. So on this space we talk to entrepreneurs where they come and share their journey with us. Today's video we have a faith organizer. She's going to introduce herself and what she does as she's going to share her story with us. So hi,
how are you?
I'm good.
Yes. Yes, this is Faith the organizer. Faith the organizer is what? An entrepreneur. Yes. I've been in this industry for about 5 years. I began in 2017. Yes, and slowly grow to tunaendelea ku grow and kuendelea to tell ourselves out there, because you see this is a new industry.
Yeah.
Especially in Kenya, so tunajaribu kujiuza and convincing people that indeed organizing is a job. Yes.
Okay. So what do you do?
So we basically keep things in order. Can I say that? Keep things in order, because when we talk about organizing, most people, the first thing that comes to their mind is events.
Yeah.
So mtu anakuuliza, oh, unafanyanga events? You're like, no, I don't do events. Then what do you do? Yeah, so you tell them you organize their spaces. Their spaces. And spaces, I mean, from your house, the things that you use, kitchen, bedrooms. We mainly deal with your space, your personal space.
Where did you start from? Did you see yourself doing this when you were younger? Or this was your passion but you didn't know? What happened?
I didn't know.
Uh-huh.
Actually, I never knew what I was doing. But everything is driven by passion. It just began by... It's the passion that I had for organized spaces that brought me here. And I used to feel whenever I would go places, even it started kitambo, but I didn't know what kind of person I was. I thought it was just a lifestyle like any other, or maybe not even a lifestyle, someone growing like anybody else. I didn't know that I had this kind of OCD thing, and I didn't know even what that meant. Anyway, it never bothered me. So mimi nilikuwa naishi tu maisha yangu kawaida. But even those people I schooled with, later on in life is when they would say, oh, by the way, you used to be like this and that in school. This is what you used to do, your things. So slowly, slowly, yeah, we come in life, you know, tuko na nyumba zetu, and you want to make your house beautiful. Now, for me, I would make my house look nice, yes. But I would want to forever see it look nice. Like, at not even one point in time, ningetaka kupata nguo kwa bed, you know. As in, ama maybe I find utensils on the sink. As much as I began life simple, tu kama kawaida like anybody else, in a bedsitter. But it was not a kawaida, like a normal bedsitter. Now, when I throw back, I never used to know if I was... You know, I had this Kanei's house, but now when I go back, I feel like, yeah, by the way, I had a good house. And not because it was furnished with expensive things, no, but it had everything that I needed. Everything had its home. So it's passion-driven, and I never need putting food on my table and what have you. No. I have never thought about it like that. In fact... I was in a different, completely different field.
Yeah.
Yes. I was in a different field completely. I did finance in school. Finance and organizing zinapatana wapi. Yes, and I've been employed. Yeah, I've been employed for about 11 years until I left employment and now started doing this full time. There's nothing but like waking up and living your dream and doing something you love, because you never get tired of doing it. But if you do something that you're just doing it for a pay, then you end up, either you do it wrong Mm-hmm. And one day you wake up and you're tired.
And you're not ready to love.
You're not ready. Yes. So if you do something that you love and something you feel, yani you're motivated, you feel, kama ujafanya hiyo kitu, maisha iendelee, you're not feeling so good. It's always good to do what you love. Because when I wake up in the morning and I know I'm going to this house and tomorrow I'm going to the other house like that, I feel so good about myself. Let's learn to listen to our children. Because I remember when I was young, I wanted to do fashion design. That's what I wanted to do when I was joining campus. Lakini, you mentioned that thing to your parents, my friend. Hey, wanaona ni kama sasa mtoto wangu anataka kushona nguo. You know.
Yeah.
But come to think of it, if I did that thing, but you see, still, fashion design and organizing, azijachana sana, still, I was somewhere. But you know, since hakuna course inaitwa organizing, ama inaitwa, you know, making your words orderly, ama this and that, in school, we never get to know about these things. And that's why it's very hard for us to approach clients outside there and tell them, let me do this work for you, and then you pay me. So, the moment we sat down and we agreed, yes, I'm doing this for a pay, it was very hard to convince clients and tell, especially here in Kenya. It's being done out there, by the way. It's being done out there. And in fact, they have even, it's like you take your own section, which will be handling, like, utapata mtu koroiro, nana handle clients wa kajiando, you get it? So you take, you like, in a certain section, and that is where the people who need your services will be getting you from. But here, hapa, before even you convince a client, it used to be hard, but right now it's easy.
Mm-hmm.
Things have started changing with time. Lakini, singewai imagine that hii kazi itawai nilipa. Hata nikianza, most of the people walinishanga sana.
How did you convince, like, someone? Now, I want to organize your home. Your first client. How was the experience? Because now, somebody to trust you with their home, it's either you're a close friend, you're a family,
yes.
You're a family, or you're a relative.
Mm.
But somebody from nowhere, I want to organize your home.
Mm.
Maybe you can't organize their sitting room, you
yes.
must go to the kitchen,
yes.
their dream. How was it first?
Sasa, hey, hiyo ndi inakuanga the biggest issue.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure there are so many people out there who wants their home organized. You want to come back after whole day work and find your home is just telling you karibu.
Yeah.
You know,
you just smile.
Ukiingia too heavy. You don't want even to, you know, you feel like just standing and just admiring your space. But that is not the case in our houses nowadays. Because utapata maybe uko na watoi, the house girl who is there probably, or the house manager overwhelmed na mtoto. Kazi hazifanyiki the way they are supposed to be. There is no system in your house that is supposed to guide this house manager. That these are the things that you're supposed to do for them to be able to maintain your home organized. So, unapata kuenda pale alafu unambia clients, you know, me, I can do this and that. Eh? Of course, nowadays, there is social media. You sell yourself through photos and all. But clients anataka kujua. From these photos, yes, this is your work. I want now to meet the you know. Tell me what exactly do you do, you know. And you tell them the exact thing that you do. But it takes a person a lot of courage and trust to akubali that uingie kwa hiyo bedroom yake. Hata mgeni ama relative, see what you ingia bedroom. And most of our sitting room, living rooms, they're usually very neat. Wait until we get a bedroom. Everywhere, even where the kids play, where the kids learn, it's just chaotic. But we want to be at that space, at that point of life where niki invite mgeni kwangu anaweza ingia. You know, my spaces, I am not even scared of you seeing, you know, my mess. There is no mess. Ukifungua wardrobe hivi hakuna nguo inakuangukia. Everything is set. If it's the kids, you've taught them, this is the system we are keeping in our house. They know how to to run around and do things around. Wanajua wakitoa wanafaa warudishe na warudishe wapi.
Mm-hmm.
You see, that is the kind of system I'm talking about. Because unless you have like a system, then everything will always be all over. I want to really appreciate my very first client. They believed in me even before they knew what I was capable of. And they were not relatives. They were not even very, very close people who knew me. But they believed in me, yeah? And whatever I did there, those are the kind of photos I will show you even to date and tell you this was my first client. You'll not believe it was my first job because I did it with my whole heart. In fact, tulikuwa tunalipisha pesa hata tukitoa expenses, uwezi rudi home. Yes, because you see, what you're looking for is that work, the final product, yeah? But unafanya willingly because you see, it's out of passion again.
Yeah.
So as much as kama unalipwa kiasi kidogo ama mingi, whatever is driving is passion, it's not money. So even when you do something bad, you're not even ashamed ama unapoteza time kuiredo tena.
Mm-hmm.
No, you just redo it again and do it nicely because my happiness ni ile.
Unaona
ile neatness, yes. Lakini unaona ile picture, the way you capture a client akiingia mahali penye maybe they have left you doing this and they come, ile first impression venye anaangalia anaona, that one just sends chills down me and I feel so good because I think that is all I need to see from my clients, to be happy and to be thrilled and, you know, and see, yeah, by the way, I didn't have this, you know. Even business registration was a problem. There is no such industry for organizers.
That's true.
Yes. Hata ukiangalia unaweka other. Ukiweka other, it does not go through. I had my biggest challenge was registering the business. Yeah, because there was no industry to categorize your name in. Yeah, what you're doing. Yeah. But slowly, I believe tutajulikana.
Mshajulikana.
Tunataka tujulikane zaidi, tujulikane by even incorporation, nini, companies act, and hizo vitu zote. At least they know that we are there and we need our guidelines. You know, tunataka ka chapter yetu that says this is what we do and this is, because also, unaona, if I come and tell you nakuja kwa bedroom yako,
mm-hmm.
what is the first thing that you think about? Nakuja kufanya. And apart from nakuja kufanya, you start thinking, kai, na vile bedroom yangu inakuanga, kai, na vinyo naikanga. As those things don't bother us,
mm-hmm.
the way we find it, you will not find it next time when you're coming. You'll find it different. So motivation yetu ni kukuacha mahali penye tu kukupata.
Yeah.
Yes. And for you, there are so many other benefits besides the space being organized. There are so many other benefits, including having peace of mind, time saving, because if I organize your talks today, what does that mean? The moment you want a talk, you know where to find talks.
Yeah.
You're not going to look for talks. Pale kwa kitanda ya mtoto, hapo chini, when you unhung last week, you never folded. So, even the person who is doing your house, hata kwa na hard time. Yeah? Clothes have been washed. Clothes need to be put where they're supposed to be. Anajua hizi nguo zinafaa kuenda wapi. Yes. Yeah, so we are making work easy for ourselves and even work easy for the people who are working for us or who are working in our houses. Yeah.
Okay. Umetuambia, when you're growing up, you had this organizing you that you didn't know that one day it's going to be.
Yes.
And at what point did you now come and sit and say, anyway, if you took this to others, I've earned something. So now you turn that skill into a business opportunity for you. What is that situation that drove you towards that?
Okay. I'm a married woman, and I am a mother.
Yeah.
A mother of four children. So you can imagine what kind of a house I would have, or a home I would have, if me myself entirely, I have not reorganized my life.
Yeah.
And not even forgetting that I am born in a family, in a large family of 13 children. So I have had really from birth, I have had to continually change my life and decide, hapa, unajuka last born wa 13, lazima ujitokeleze wakuone, wajue uko bado. Otherwise, first born na second born, utakuwa nasema, aya, uya nakuanga. So lazima you find a way of you being seen, you know, wajue bado uko. Anyway, so slowly, slowly like that, I had to do my things. Ukiwa na watoto wengi kwenyu, you can imagine, socks zinafuliwa pamoja, nguo zinafuliwa pamoja. How do you else know your things if you're not organized? Yeah? But I want to thank my mother. She used to be this organized lady. I think that's where I got it from. Because she would organize all our things and she would know what things would belong to who. As in, like, clearly, that one, she has all the credits. Yeah, so when we, if we grew, because we grew up seeing that, you'd also don't want to see being clumsy in your life because you didn't grow up seeing that. Me making this a business came up as back in 2016 when I gave birth to my third born, and I had no time for myself to do my house. We had moved into a new house and I really love doing my spaces, but sikuwa na hiyo energy ya kufanya space yangu venye nataka. So I went ahead and started searching for an organizer on the on net. Nilitafuta organizers in Nairobi. Nilikuwa napata tu wa nje. There was no organizer in Nairobi. So I sat down and said, if you'd come as a visitor, by the way, you'd come and unakuja tu unanisaidia kufanya kazi. Nothing else. You help me work. So we put up the house and the house was ready in like a month's time. Good thing is that when we were doing the house, we knew what would go where. So when we are organizing, we knew what, after sorting, these things are supposed to go there and there. But I sat down again and decided I don't want to go back to business. So what do I do? I decided I am calling my household. Nawaita mkutano. Wajue ya kwamba. 1, 2, 3, 4 is how things are supposed to be done. And if they are not done like this, sasa hapa unajua, you know what? If you don't communicate your expectation, you end up being frustrated. So to avoid frustration, is good you communicate. Mukwe atfa. Now, ukipata, if you find something which is not supposed to be where it is, then you have a question to ask. And that person needs to answer because that thing needs to be somewhere. So that is the kind of conversation we had in my house. And it was not easy. It was not easy at all because everybody started complaining. But I told them, baby, we are not having it otherwise. This is the way it is going to be. This is the system I have put in place. And this is the way it's going to be. Hakuna nje ingine. Yeah, so some people felt like they were being harassed and subjected to stuff that they, you know, they were not used to so much. You know, when we were in the other house, sometimes ungepatana na kitu unasema, maybe ni kwa sababu hakuna nini? Hakuna space. Here we have created and it is there. So yeah, my hubby sat me down one day because he also felt a bit harassed and he told me, sasa wewe, utatukazia hii maisha mpaka lini? Have you thought about doing this thing to other people for a pay? Okay, it didn't hit me that time. But later, as I was doing my errands there kwa nyumba, ikajiuliza aliniambia nini. Then it hit me. I was on maternity leave. When I went back to work, I was not the same. I went there with another mind. I started searching. I researched. I did a lot of research in organizing. I started now thinking I need to register my business. What do I call it? It's about me. Then I came up, yeah, it needs to have a faith. And then it needs to have something to be organized. So that's how Faith the Organizer was born. Then he helped me come up with a logo. That's the beauty of if you engage your partner into
your business.
Yes. So he had an idea of what I wanted, but I had all the, you know, I knew exactly what I wanted. So I did my list, my to-do list. Nika go through, I would tick every day, what I was supposed to do. And yeah, that's how I began and started looking for my first client.
Wow.
So my first client, niliwaonyesha pictures za nyumba yangu. I took photos of a few works I had done in my house.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what I was showing.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. And they believed me, thanks to Frida and Faith.
What are some of the challenges that you see?
Before, nilikuwa napata challenge, I never used to do site visits.
Mm-hmm.
So somebody would call me, ask them, what is the size of the house? They tell me, it's a one-bedroom house. And they're like, ah, one-bedroom, siku moja, hiyo namaliza, nachapa namaliza. Wait until you get there, my dear. That is like a three-bedroom house. The things that are in that house. So, hiyo ni challenge moja. The fact that sisi kama Africans, by the way ni baraka, you know, we believe that it's a blessing to jigambe too for who we are. We believe that having more is good for us. But we forget, until you have less, that's when you know living with less is more.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So, unaenda pale, unachapa job haishi. One bedroom, job haishi, and you're not alone. Unaenda the following day, job haishi. So before I could be able to look at work and quantify it and be able to tell, like, here I need 3 people to work for 2 days. It took me some time. And it costed me because I would quote for work of for 1 day, yet nikazi siku tatu. So you can imagine, and you have to finish. Kwa sababu, what you're looking for is for this client, a quick client mwingine kesho. So ukimwachisha, ukimwachana na yeye hivyo, how will that client market you? And then also the other thing, passion was driving me. I really wanted to see the end product of this house. Itakuwa aje. But the beauty is that when you talk to clients, they come through for you. They want to declutter. So when you declutter, you are able to work now with the things that you've been left with. It's like a process. Organizing is like a process. You don't wake up and organize.
No job. At first, I was thinking organizing. I just come, you do your thing and you leave. But now when you're explaining to me, what? Where? Mbaka munenda chini ya kitanda lazima ikuwa safi.
Sisa tuachangi vitu kwa chini ya kitanda. We don't leave things under the bed unless there is no space at all. Yeah, and if there is no space at all, we really try to create storage as much as we can.
Mm-hmm.
But organizing, unajua kuna mwenye anaamka na sema, hey, me, I've been seeing people organize their houses now. I want to organize mine. You wake up. You go shopping, you buy containers, you buy organizers, you come back. Nothing fits. Nothing goes anywhere. Hakuna kitu inaingia mahali popote. So, you go back to zero. Hiyo ndio shida yetu. We want to buy everything that is being sold out there. We forget that we have to do it in steps. Like if you want to organize your small house, like let's say you're a small your bedroom alone. You don't wake up and start organizing without having done the steps of organizing, which is decluttering number one. You need to remove things that you're not using. Unajua sisi wa Kenya tunawekanga vitu, tunaziweka, tunaenda kwa marafiki wanatoa zao tunachukua. Eh? Ai, unatoa hii kwa nini?
Na vile inakaa supu.
Imagine it becomes yours and it doesn't even fit you. Just because inaka supu, it is now yours. Eh? You're forgetting you've got no space.
Yeah.
You're forgetting you will not even use it. Even if you had space, why would you keep something that will not fit you? That you will not wear? Yeah? So, hiyo imekuwa challenge yetu kubwa sana. To convince somebody that they need to declutter and remove things that they are not using in Kenya. It's been our biggest challenge, but slowly, imagine, by the way, we declutter professionally, we take you through the process nicely, until you get comfortable into sorting, removing those things, then we do not allow you to do so, because otherwise you'll blame me, and if kama zile vitu they have not left your house, they will definitely find your way back, their way back, yes, into your storage again. So you have to be set and ready. It's not an easy exercise. Yes.
Okay, now talking about the containers and everything, do you have a store where you sell the containers maybe the things you use to organize?
So when we were organizing, yes, we do have a store. When we were organizing, when we were starting, we never used to have a place where we buy these things. So majorly, I would like source them from a supermarket, not something you like, but something which is close. You know, the beauty about organizers and containers is that the most of them are multi-purpose. You just need to identify your need, and then you'll be able to get something for your space, and at least make sure it fits where you want it to fit. So you are able to use it for different purposes altogether. So to go to my source, even inje, I would even bring things from outside. If I have a booking with a later date, I'm an source from other stores. But pole pole, I really feel like if I brought in containers, and then at least I sell them at a discount to the clients I'm organizing for, then I'll be doing them justice, because they'll not go out there looking for things, because these are things that I know they are meant for, they'll be good for this purpose that they have. And then number two, the client doesn't start moving around. In fact, we even encourage that if you've spotted something even in the market that you want to use, tell us, we can even go and get it for you. At least I'll approve it, because if it is me organizing that space, because I will know itatoshea na itabeba zile vitu zenye tunaenda kuweka. So hata nikikuja kwako and I put for you a container, and kidogo kidogo you feel like maybe we realize the container is not fit to be here, we just remove and put what is supposed. So imagine if you had bought it like in a supermarket, utarudisha. Uwezi rudisha. Hizo containers zinakuwa clutter zenyewe sasa kwa nyumba. Unaanza kutafuta kwa kuzipeleka. Yeah, so for us, we just come, like, if you've told me it's kitchen, tuna load the boot with kitchen stuff. I don't want to know whether I will use or not use. Ikifika mahali na nione, I need to use this, and you approve, yes, you need this, then we go ahead and use. Yes.
Okay. Now, at this point, unajua we didn't know about organizing as a business. We got Nigerian with all your mother, sisters to do that.
Kwa nyumba. So, you
know that this is a business. Now it is a business.
Yes.
How do you feel at saying that we, like, say people are starting to identify you and your business? How does that make you feel?
It makes me feel good. But it even makes me feel better when I know that there is something positive coming out of it.
Yeah.
Because you see, when you get organized, there's so much peace in that house, including everybody, even the little child.
Even fresh air.
There is a lot of motivation even to work. Kama ni kitchen, unajua vitu ziko hapa, ziko pale, unasikia unaweza pika anything at any time. Even if you have a partner who loves cooking, akienda pale kitchen aanze kukuuliza kitu fulani kwa api. You know, it's easy, as in, even if you had a visitor coming to cook for you, or maybe even a caterer, they'll come, cook, maliza, put back the things, na waende, you just find food. So that gives me a lot of peace, and I feel so good, because I know that there's something good happening in this home because of me.
Yeah.
Some go ahead and watch my videos and not even engage me in what they need to do, and they call me, they're like, "Faith, I watched your videos, and imagine I did this and that, what do you think?" And they're like, "By the way, my house is never the same again." Yeah. I teach, I train house elves on how to be able to manage an organized home, but I prefer to train house elves for houses that I have been able to organize. Because you see, already there is a system.
Yeah.
Yeah. So training them and telling them this is the way things are supposed to be is easy. If there is no system, hata nikimwambia nini, they will not do it because still they are, it's not done. Unless you yourself as a parent or as a mother, you take it up to yourself, uende, organize your nyumba, and then now you train. And na hiyo ndio challenge kubwa sana. Tunaitanga house help. We think house helps, they are coming to make our houses. Yet, they are supposed to come and maintain them. Vile wamezipata, wanafaa kuzimake better. Not because they are knowledgeable, but wanafaa wa maintain. Na ukiona afanyi ile kitu yenye ifai, you should be able to correct them. And ask them, because you found this house like this and that. Why is it like this and that? Sasa, it's vice versa. Wanapatanga zikiwa clumsy, na unataka zikai mzuri. And they don't know where to start. Hata anza kukwambia jenga wardrobes, jenga this, weka storage. It is up to you to know that you need this and that and that. Na kuleta vitu kwa nyumba is not organizing. Yes. You can bring, I'm sure so many of us have even so many gadgets. Za kitchen zenye hatujawahi tumia. Tunapatanga tu tukileta. Kuleta, kuleta, kuleta. Unakuja, even there is no space to put those gadgets. No space to put those gadgets. The day of decluttering is when you're like, aya, hizi zilikuwa mbili. You know? But you see, now that you know, you will not get there again. Challenge yetu kubwa tena. Ni trust.
Oh, by the way,
yeah. Yes, trust. Utapata, mimi sitaki kutrust. Sasa nita kutrust aje na bedroom yangu. Yeah? You've seen...
Unakata trust.
Yes. As in, a warning, there is no way you can come to my bedroom. Maybe mtu atakwambia, just come and organize my baby's closet, my baby's bedroom, because bado hajafika pale. Yeah? It's okay to test your waters, maybe it's very okay, but our work is purely based on integrity.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not sure about myself and how I work, even outside in Europe and even in the US, where organizing is embraced, hakuna organizer atasema anafanya kazi ya organizing if you're not a person of high integrity.
Absolutely. How did you, like, first of all, let's start looking at you. Is it something that you had planned? I'm not doing it alone. Let me just work with her and catch up a kazi and.
Mungai Eve, Mungai Eve, I've worked with a number of celebrities, but it was not like my plan. It is just a night, my time to work with celebrities. Ilikuja tu, just woke up one day and yeah, it's here, so you can't run away. You just embrace it and move on. So my celebrities are my clients, just like any other. Yeah. When they talk about you, they don't talk about you ati ndio wakuuze uko nje. Wanaongea kitu iko.
Okay? And they appreciate your work.
Yes. Mentality ya watu ni eti.
They are paid for everything.
Yes, for everything. No. Even if you're paying, they should be. You should pay for something that is there, for something that can be seen, for something that is worth it. I'm the one who DM'd Eve. Eve is such a down-to-earth girl. I'm the one who DM'd her. I woke up one day and I was like, let me DM her. And I sent her a message. I told her we do this and that and that. Then one day when she needed the service, she could not remember my name. So alinitafuta akakosa. So then again I said, why am I just keeping? But she said she'll get back. Let me just show her. She's so easy. So nikamshtua tena akaniambia, "Guy, I've been looking for you. I didn't know how I had saved you nini." Nikamwambia, "Yes, I'm here." Akaniambia, "Please come and help me arrange my sitting room." Yeah, so I went and I met Eve. Hata ilikuwa inakaa kama tushaikutana. It's like we've known each other, like, you know? Yeah, and we worked. She gave us the work at hand, tukafanya, tukamaliza. Yeah. And from there on, it was, sasa hiyo inakuanga, she's like a My elder daughter. Kenuthia, official Kenuthia. I've worked with Jackie Matubia. I've worked with the Wajizas.
Mm-hmm.
And all of them have been amazing people. Good trust issues. When we are training,
mm-hmm.
that is one thing we train on. Even when we are hiring.
Mm-hmm.
Mimi kama unajua uko na trust issues, haki don't dare come my way because it will not be an easy, it will not be easy because it's not. I cannot even imagine somebody picking something from a client. Yeah, but we definitely have tried, have to manage it. Eh?
Mm-hmm.
As much as you trust somebody, it's always good. We have a way of managing it. We don't go into clients' houses with our bags.
Mm-hmm.
We leave them where we put our stuff, and we our clothes are just uniform. Atuendi pale na vitu. Hata kama tuko na food or anything, tunaacha where it's supposed to be. Tell my clients if probably maybe you have something that you would feel you're not comfortable, or it being there when we are working, then kindly pick it and keep it. Not within the house, because sisi tunaanzanga chini, juu, mpaka chini. So, hata ukificha tutaiona. So, the best thing is to take it with you. Yes, and I'm not saying this so that you feel threatened. I'm saying this to tell you that that's my work. Because wezi niambia, your work is to organize this closet. I just naorganize mahali penye kuna the clothes. And then I leave the top cabinet. I'll not have done anything. Yeah. If it's the bedroom, I have to work under the bed. I have to check out things. The only thing that we leave out, we don't scrutinize or go through it unless with the permission of the client are the documents. Receipt, yenye na feel probably nafani trash. Maybe it's the one that you've been looking for so many years. So if we have to work on documents, you have to be there for us to work on those documents. When you're there, it's filing and putting them into folders and what have you. The other thing, bedrooms. Bedrooms is also very hard for me to declutter when you're not there.
Mm-hmm.
So first things first, I tell people if I'm decluttering your bedroom, unless you don't want decluttering, but I always insist that you need to declutter. Hata mwenye anasema hakuna kitu ya kutoa, there is only something to take out.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. So we have to be there with you so that I take you through that process when you're there. Then you're able to tell me, this one, I'll keep. This one, hata sisi tunaona imeisha, hii ni ya kudraw.
Mm-hmm.
So we come with baskets or maybe containers or places where we can put, draw, keep, donate, and doubt. Unajua kuna ile yenye hauko sure itaenda wapi. So tukimaliza organizing, tunarudi kwa ile doubting box. Tuangalie, what do you feel? What do you think about this? Yeah. So the car process is quite impressive.
You have any plans maybe when you're expanding, now you start from moving, to organize, cleaning, organizing, and now I'm
moving. I did moving in 2019 to 2022.
Mm-hmm.
This year, I stopped moving this year. I did not stop because it's bad.
Mm-hmm.
I just stopped, and we were doing it very well because you see, majority of our clients are clients who have moved houses and they're in a mess. They don't know where to start. So I felt, why not start providing the moving service? And if I provide the moving service, then I can organize at a go at once.
Mm-hmm.
And it was working very well. I believe those I have had the opportunity of moving them,
mm-hmm.
they have a testimony to tell, because it's been an amazing, really amazing, because we leave you all sorted. But now the challenge was, if you see something is not working for you, it's always good to let go before it's too late. So our biggest challenge was, my passion is in organizing. So you move with a plan, you know, you have to do all those processes of moving. call you like today and they tell you, I want to move on Saturday. Yeah, I want to move tomorrow. So already, probably you have a client on tomorrow whom you're doing what? Whom you're organizing for. So will you not tell this client or postpone this client so that you do a move? Or will you disappoint this client who wants to move? So the best thing I saw, let me just stick to organizing. Mm-hmm. And then I can still get to organize people's homes even after they have moved. Cleaning is now part of us.
Mm-hmm.
Although, like I said, we are starting small and then we grow.
Mm-hmm.
I want to be able to provide services which we are providing in homes, especially homes which we have been able to organize. There's something called maintenance service.
Mm-hmm.
Somebody calls you and they want you to go to their home, maybe like once a month, to be able to make sure that everything is the way it's supposed to be.
What will you do? Where can people find you if they want to reach you?
We are all over social media.
Mm-hmm.
Because we want to reach each and everybody. We're on IG, we're on Facebook, on YouTube, on Pinterest, we are on even Twitter and TikTok. Though TikTok hatujanini sana, but tunakuja sana na fujo. Yes, all of them, all the handles are Faith the Organizer. I'm starting training on potential organizers. Yes. And those who want to be able to organize other people's homes professionally. See, like kwa mka na kusema. Because also I started, as much as I woke up and decided to do it, kuna zile vitu nilipitia. Sahis, I don't have those things. So I want to train you on those things. So when you're starting, at least you're starting on a smooth path. Yes. So we'll be looking forward to training such. And it doesn't have to be physical. It can be virtual from wherever you are. Because sahi ile challenge yenye tuko nayo sana ni traveling. Because you will get clients who are Eldoret, clients who are Meru, Mombasa. And people, you know, if you get those clients, you have to travel there. You need accommodation, you need so much. So if I'm able to train other people in those towns, then imagine tuna grow every day. Na tunajulikana, there's nothing good as that. So wherever you are, you can reach out and we'll be able to strike something for you, something that can work for you. And I'll train you how to penetrate also the market, you know. And I believe I have mentored a number in the market as well.
Yeah.
And I'm happy to say that they are doing very well.
Mm-hmm.
They are doing very well, munajijua. So I feel so good. Yeah. Could you ask somebody and out there and anasema, by the way, worried not for this and that. Not this one, your baraka zangu zinakuja.
Yeah.
Hey. Baraka zangu sio kupata client peke yake. It is to for people to speak a blessing in your life. Mimi, purely, my work is based on mi natembeanga na Holy Spirit. Tunakuanga tu hivi. Hata nikipata challenge, I don't know what to do kwa client, hapa na hapa. Now, you know you can organize a space and ukiangalia unashanga, umeorganize nini? You know? Imagine it will go down, all of it. It doesn't matter. Iyo tutarudia. But sahi, kitambo it used to happen like that. But now, at least those things, now at least I have an idea. Nikiona space, I'm able to tell this space, we should do this and that.
Mm-hmm.
And then the space becomes beautiful. So even those who are organizing their homes, yeah? Those who are looking up to me to organize their homes, don't feel bad when you organize a space and you still don't like it. That is the process of organizing. Kama hujapitia hiyo ya kuangusha chini na kuanza tena, then you've not organized. Yes. Yes.
Yeah, and that's it for today. Hope you got inspired by her story. Yeah, na mkitafuta organizers, she's here for you. Yeah, I'll link her number down below. Don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and comment. Till next time, bye-bye.